As many of you guys know, I really bought a double din for the car, and I'm running the standard speakers on the car, and that's kind of a problem with the vibration I have in the car. So you guys will have to wait for the vibration for the next video, because I already shot the intro of the video, say half of the video, but because Fred is using the car for the weekend, he's traveling to Cape Town and back with the car. Unfortunately, I can't reveal the video because the video is not completed or it's not fully edited yet. And the last part of the video, I didn't film yet as well. So that's why I'm doing this video before that one. Although that one was shot before this one. So I hope you guys understand. Might be a little bit confusing. But I would just like to reveal something to all of you guys real quick. I hope you guys are going to like the reveal, because I have another takeaway package that just came in. I ordered it in the week. And there's another takeaway package coming in next week, so hopefully we can do the full installation for that. And as you guys can already guess, I actually bought an amplifier and a pair of 6x9s from Takealot, and it is one of the local brands, which is Energy Audio, because I would like to have the same setup in the car, which is the Energy Audio 4-channel amplifier 6x9s. And I already ordered the mids, which is only going to be arriving in next week. So we will just have to wait for that. But we can just start with the unboxing of the amplifier and the 6x9s. And I can just give you guys a nice overall takedown on how much everything cost me. What's the specs or the features of the amplifier as well as the 6x9s. And obviously we can do a review later about that. Guys, just keep in mind, I'm not a professional audio expert. All I know is what stands in the box, and I can literally just give my opinion on how the stuff plays and how long it lasts and stuff like that, because I saw someone commented about me giving bad feedback or not a proper review regarding the double din, and that's because I don't know much about audio. I literally just know as much as anyone else about audio, like the RMS and the watt and everything like that, and the features that's stated on the box or the packaging of the amplifiers or the speakers. So that's just me reading everything out to you guys and giving feedback to you guys and giving my personal opinion regarding the sound I am installing in my car. So I'm not a professional expert, or I'm not the expert at all. I just give my personal opinion, and I hope my personal opinion will be good enough for you to do the same or to buy the same product. Here we have the boxes. So I think the 6x9s and the amplifiers in here. I bought me some microfiber cloths once again, because all of my cloths is already used and dirty, so I think that's the cloth. This one right here is separate, because this is a liquid, and I ran out of shampoo, so I had to buy more shampoo, and this is the reason why this is in a separate package as well. So I'm just gonna start with unboxing with these two right here, because I think this is just the normal microfiber cloths, and this is the shampoo, and then we can come to the main package, which is this one right here. Well guys, so the main reason I'm doing the unboxing of these packages I recently received this morning is because I actually noticed that many of you guys actually like the unboxing videos, and you guys actually like me wasting my money on these Takealot packages and stuff like that. So that's why I'm doing another unboxing video, and clearly you guys like me wasting my money as well, and maybe like doing like a quality test on these products and stuff like that. But one thing I can mention about the microfiber cloths is that it's actually really, really nice, because I have one of these cloths in each of my cars. Like you guys can, like you guys really know, I have four cars on the yard, so I have one of these cloths in each car, and the other cloths I just literally gave away to a few friends, or it's literally really used and it's dirty. So these ones I'm going to be using for polishing, but let's put that aside. Let's get to the unboxing of the shampoo. Guys, the microfiber cloth I think cost me like 30 to 40 rand, so that's quite cheap as well. And then the shampoo, I literally pay I think 60 rand for the shampoo. And just keep in mind, you have to spend about 450 to get a free delivery from Takealot, so that's kind of amazing as well. So you don't need to pay for delivery fees. The only disadvantage from that is that you have to wait for a specific day when they are available to deliver the package to your doorstep. But that's not a problem as well. Oh, that's not a problem at all. But here we have the shampoo, as you guys can see. It is a 5 liter, and trust me, the previous shampoo lost me like, I think like a few months, so that's quite alright. And like I said, we do have a few cars on the yard, and I'm not the only one washing cars on the yard. Like most of my friends actually just come to me and come wash the cars as well. So we use a lot of shampoo, especially on our cars, and sometimes we use shampoo for other stuff as well. So to me, paying 60 rand for a 5 liter shampoo or car shampoo, it's totally worth it. I mean, like you can buy a small bottle of Shield or Meguiar's, and you're gonna pay quite a lot. And trust me, this, I think it's, yeah, Motorquip, if I'm not mistaken. They're quite alright, and the quality of the shampoo, and it makes enough bubbles, and the lubrication is quite alright, so I'm satisfied with the shampoo. Now we're into the main package. So this is the main package, and to be honest, I paid $7.99 for the 4-channel Energy Audio 5000 watt amplifier, so it's quite alright. The specs on it is quite alright, and I think I'll be able to drive a pair of mids on this amplifier and a pair of 6x9s as well. So that's the only thing I want to run on here. I initially wanted to go with a split system in front with a tweeter and a mid in front, but unfortunately I didn't find any Energy Audio split systems on Takealot, so the only ones I actually ordered was this one. So, or the next packet that's supposed to arrive in the week, which is hopefully Wednesday. So the only stuff in this package, unfortunately, today will be the amplifier as well as the 6x9. So we can literally just check out the specs, the quality of the packaging, to make sure that whenever you're going to receive a package, that it won't get damaged, anything like that. Because Takealot, they make a lot of effort, especially with the packaging and especially with fragile items. So here, we already have our 6x9s, which is this. 6x9s, which is actually fresh on the market, and it's a 600 watt max power three-way speaker, which is actually not too bad at all. Energy Audio is a recent brand that actually came on the South African market, if I'm not mistaken. It's very popular in Cape Town, and if you actually go check on YouTube, you won't get much reviews on Energy Audio except by SoundMax itself. And to be honest, with my experience with Energy Audio this far, with a few of my friends buying the subs, the monoblocks, the double dins or radios, I mean, like, I think it's a really, really proper brand for just coming into the market recently. So I'm quite fond of Energy Audio through my double din, and that's why I'm running a complete setup with Energy Audio. Here we have the 6x9s, and obviously here we got the amplifier, which is quite packaged alright as well. So as you guys can see right here, 5000 watt 4 channel, quite alright. Here are the specs on it right here, the features, which is not too bad at all. And the packaging on it is quite alright. Oh shit, there's something fell. But yeah, I'm gonna open this right now. While Jody is busy unboxing the amplifier real quick, I will be unboxing the 6x9. So I just need to loosen a few stuff or stickers here, and I can literally just get it out. Just give me a few seconds to get this thing out. Here we have the 6x9s, which is not too bad at all, especially if you check out the magnet. And that is the power, the 600 watt max power on the 6x9s. It gives 45 watts RMS, three-way, not too bad at all. I'm super excited to actually fit this, or these pair of 6x9s in my car. Unfortunately, I will have to wait for the mods, but I think we can start installing the 6x9s in the car as soon as possible, whenever we have time. And here we have the amplifier. Guys, just keep in mind, I paid 800 rand for this amplifier. It was on a discount, or it still is on a discount on Takealot. And obviously we have the 6x9s here. I paid 400 rand for these 6x9s. So in total for this and the 6x9s, I paid 1200 rand with free delivery to your doorstep, and I got it like within 2 days. So if you guys are keen to buy some sound for your car, definitely go check it out on Takealot. Maybe you guys can check it out at SoundMatch as well, or whatever sound places or sound shops in your area. But for me to get it delivered to my doorstep, you're not paying any petrol money to go fetch it. They literally deliver it to your doorstep, and you're buying it brand new. Because I wanted to buy this exact same 6x9 second hand with the amplifier, and the guy charged me 1200 rand for that, and it was second hand, which was obviously used, you understand. So That's why I went with the brand new option, and I know I really want to put the best of the best in my car at the moment, because like I said, this is going to be a show car. I want the best of the best in the car. I still need to run some thicker wires in the car and get everything sorted for the sound system, but for now everything is 100% sorted. And here obviously we have the 6.9 box. I just want to get the features on the box. Everything stated right here is said on Takealot as well, so you know exactly what you are buying in the description of the Takealot advertisement. So that's where you know what you are buying, what the specs are of the 6.9s, and everything is stated in the description of the ad. So there you have everything right there, and obviously you guys can see it is brand new and there's nothing wrong with it, so I'm totally excited for this. And obviously you just check out the features or the specs on the amplifier. Here we have everything as well. So it's a 4-channel, and as you guys can see right there, it's 60x4 watt RMS, 4-channel, not too bad. And to me personally, I think this is more than enough for the 6.9s and the 2 mids. Just keep in mind, you can run 1 subwoofer and 2 speakers on here, which is not too bad. It states here SVC, so I'm sure you can most probably run a smaller DVC on here, if I'm not mistaken. But for me personally, I'm totally happy with it. And you guys can see right here, you can adjust it quite right as well. So you get like the HPF, this is obviously for the front mids, or if you run 6.9, you can run it on these 2 channels right here. And obviously you get the main channel, which you can run either SVC subwoofer, or you can run just your normal 6.9s or mids or speakers on the channel as well, because you can literally set it from HPF, LPF, or full. HPF is for just high frequency, that's for your 6.9s, and the LPF, that's whenever you're going to run a subwoofer. And obviously the full, that's a little bit of bass, a little bit of vocal all in one, that's if you want to run that one as well. But in my case, I'll be running both. I'll be running all 4 channels on HPF, because I'll be running the 6.9s on there as well as the mids. Well guys, behind me you guys can see I unboxed everything, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video, because like you guys can see, I do spend a lot of money on the car, and I hope you guys appreciate that, because for me to get this money, I have to work weekends, and that's why I can't make a lot of videos like I previously did. Luckily for you guys and for me, I only start studying in January once again, so I am on holiday, if you can state it that way. So that way I actually have more time to make videos, to think out videos, and I'm gonna try to collab with a few local YouTubers as well in this holiday. I'm gonna try to go to few events this holiday as well, but the main problem I'm having is that whenever I'm working, that's usually when the events occur. Like, make example, the events will be on a Saturday, and I usually work on a Saturday, and that's the reason why I'm never at the event. And as you guys can see, I always need the cash, because I need to pay my debts, I need to pay the expenses, I need to pay my modifications for the cars. And I know you guys, once I'm more on the content and GTI content and Caddy content, but the problem is that I can only spend on one car at a time. So I hope you guys can understand that. I hope you guys appreciate what I'm actually like doing to the car, what I'm buying for the car. Obviously it's for my benefit, and it's a nice review for you guys as well, because now you guys can literally just go and take a lot and literally get it delivered to your doorsteps. That's not a problem at all. So I'm gonna do a nice small review on these items, like in the sense of how it plays, how you can tune it and stuff like that. Like I said, I'm no expert, but I like my clarity in the car, especially coming from my mid speakers and my 6.9s coming from the back. Keep in mind, I won't be cutting any holes in my backboard, because I want this car still to be looked as standard as possible. So the covers where the original speakers come out in the Mark 1 at the back, just next to the board, I will be trying to fit these 6.9s in there. I'm going to try to get some brackets, because that's the exact same way I did it with Lola. Hopefully it will work out with this car as well, and hopefully we can get everything installed in the week. I'm super excited, I can't wait. You guys are gonna like the next video, because the next video is gonna be the video where the roof vibrates. So hope you guys can appreciate that. I hope it's gonna be the next video, because Fred will only be getting my car back on Monday, and today is Saturday. This video might just be uploaded by Sunday. I hope you guys can appreciate that. And I hope you guys like the video, share the video, just keep in mind the giveaway is coming soon because I'm just finalizing a few things and then we can get this giveaway on the road. I'll give you guys a full description of how to enter the competition. And the prizes are quite alright. I'm not sure if I want to give just away one prize or first, second and third prize because then there's more people that can get like prizes from Late Late Customs. So guys, I hope you guys liked today's video. Please like, please subscribe and please do click the notification bell to get notified whenever a new video is uploaded on YouTube from Late Late Customs. Guys, be safe this festive season. Don't race, don't drink on the road. Just keep in mind, if they catch you by a Friday, you will be sitting the entire weekend in jail if you're under the influence of alcohol. So don't drink and drive. Please guys, if you have coil loops in your car, seat the car higher. If you have cut springs or lowering kits in your car, put in your standard springs, drive high this weekend because they are targeting our stance community. So guys, let's not fight back, let's just leave it right there. Let's lift up our cars, let's drive our cars a little bit higher as usual. Set up your coil, just put back your standard springs. Let's just enjoy this festive season and be safe on the road. Guys, keep in mind, stop racing and go stance. But not this festive season, we will continue in January.